The future solution requires a unified effort, given that we have until 2050 to achieve net zero emissions. Hull City Council are committed to driving climate change solutions within the city through a sustainable development approach. The approach has the potential to set an example for other urban areas, showcasing how to make a positive environmental impact.
As a city surrounded by water, Hull has always been both dependent on and vulnerable to its powers. So as well as working hard to protect residents from flooding, Hull City Council is now harnessing the power of water to create the opportunities offered by renewable energy.
We take such pride in the work that we do here, the product that we produce, and of course the difference that we can make in generating clean energy for generations to come.
Siemens Gamesa has been a world leader in the manufacture of wind turbine blades for 40 years and has been doing so in Hull for the past seven. For its director, Hull was an obvious location choice.
Hull was specifically chosen for a number of reasons. One of its proximity to the market, the offshore wind market in the UK, but also in addition to that, to the workforce that's here, the talent, the energy, the enthusiasm that the workforce brings, as well as, of course, the port facilities being located close to the North Sea and the window to Europe.
Siemens Gamesa has gone from strength to strength and now makes blades which are more than 108 metres long here in Hull, as well as being the only place in the world to make recyclable blades. For both city and company, the relationship has proved mutually beneficial.
Obviously the direct jobs that we've created, more than 1,000 in total, but also those in support functions as well, which are crucial to our success. But in addition to that, of course, the inward investment. I think we'd like to think as well that we've been able to work in partnership with both the City Council and Future Humber to promote the region, to show what's possible, to show what's capable of and what the Hull and the surrounding regions can bring to net zero and a clean carbon future.
As a world leader in the manufacture of wind turbines, Siemens Gamesa is putting Hull on the global green technology map. Meanwhile, on a local level in the city itself, the council is working hard to put in place preventative measures to counteract the impact of climate change. The city council has worked hard to try to prevent scenes like this from 2007 from happening again, when Hull experienced widespread flooding across the city with thousands of properties damaged. Arthur Moon has lived on this flood-prone Hull street for more than 20 years. To the delight of residents, the Living with Water partnership between Yorkshire Water, Hull City and East Riding Councils and the Environment Agency has recently installed £2 million worth of permeable paving, funded by Yorkshire Water, to remedy the ongoing problem of surface water flooding.
Recently, we've had some heavy rain, right? And the road performed what it's supposed to do. It absorbs the water, there's nothing there after it stops raining. That's what we like about it.
In times of very heavy extreme rainfall, the water is actually stored in this lagoon up to the brim, and we're holding it, simply put, in a managed environment.
Constructed after the 2007 floods, this storage lagoon is just one way Hull City Council's working in partnership with other agencies to protect residents from flooding.
We've worked with the Environment Agency on the Humber Hull Frontages Scheme, which has protected many, many properties in the city from tidal flooding. We've worked with East Riding of Yorkshire Council, our neighbouring authority, on these surface water schemes here. We're working with Yorkshire Water to retrofit sustainable drainage, such as Rosmead Street, across the city. And then together we're all working on that sort of community engagement, that community awareness raising, so working with children, working with schools, to really get that ramped up understanding of flooding and to bring in that multi-benefit to show that it's not always a negative, but there are plenty of opportunities there as well.
For the City Council, Hull's future is bright as long as adaptation to climate change remains at the forefront of their agenda.
The work that we've done to adapt to flooding is an integral part of that adaptation process, but also it's much wider than that, is recognising the impacts of heat and how that will affect us, and also the impacts of a lack of water as well. So we have to balance all of the issues, understand how those will affect the city, affect the buildings, affect our communities. And it's also really important for us to understand the social dimensions to the impacts of climate change.
There'll always be more work to do. Nature will always be one step ahead of us, but I feel we've got a good grounding as to what we need to do, and we're doing it now.
As a city committed to sustainable development while adapting to climate change and driving forward green solutions, Hull is undoubtedly an example for other cities to follow in the future.